स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई विल टॉक अबाउट ऑन द टॉपिक नो मैन आर फॉरेन. नो मैन आर फॉरेन, दिस पोएम इज ऑल अबाउट ह्यूमन बीइंग्स. आल्सो इट टेल्स दैट एवरी ह्यूमन बीइंग दैट लाइव्स ऑन दिस अर्थ आर ब्रदर्स एंड आर द सेम. मोर ओवर वी ऑल हैव सम काइंड ऑफ बॉडी एंड नीड सन, एयर, वाटर एंड क्लोथ टू कवर अस. We all walk the land and feed ourselves with the harvest of this earth. Upon death, people will bury us in the same land. In addition, we all do work and sleep and wake up, loves and wants to love in return for others. But we human beings hate each other, and because of this we live on by hating and fighting with one another. Further, it is humans who pollute the environment by hating and fighting with one another. Further, it is humans who pollute the environment by taking into consideration its bad impact on other people. In the beginning, the poet says that no man are strange and no country is foreign. So the poet tries to remove all the borders of countries from the earth's surface. Only then no country will be foreign. Also, when there will be no borders, then no country will be foreign. And we can feel free to move around. In this way, the entire earth is one. And all the people who live on the earth belongs to one human race. Moreover, inside the uniforms of soldiers from different countries, humans are the same, because God has made us all similarly. We all breathe in the same way. After that, poet says that all the soldiers are our brothers, as we all walk the same Mother Earth. And upon death, will bury in the same earth. In the next part, they refer to people of other countries. We also fight with them, discriminate them, and call them foreigners. He also says that nature has given them plenty, just like it did to us. God has given everyone equal air, water, and sunlight. Which means God does not differentiate. When there is no war, we all do farming. We live a comfortable life and eat things given by nature. In addition, he points out that during war and winter, we starve, and the people of another country also face the same things. So the poet wants to say that we and foreigners of other countries are the same. Further, he says that they have the same kind as ours and they work hard like us. The poet gives all these examples to express the readers that there is no difference between people of a different country. Poet asks the reader to remember something. He further says that keep in mind that God has bestowed our enemies with a similar appearance to us. God has given them similar eyes that open and shut like ours. God has also given them strength which we can win through love. And on every land, life is the most common thing. Moreover, when we realize that they are like us, then there will be no war. When someone tells us to hate someone of another country and think them as our enemy, and we do that, then we deprive, condemn, and cheat ourselves. The poet says that we should stay away from such negativity. During the war, both parties bear losses. This is the reason why people say the war is not in anyone's favor. when we pick any weapon against someone, we should recall one thing. When we pick a weapon against anyone, we defile the earth with their blood. As in war, there is a fire, death and bloodshed. The dead bodies make the earth impure. The war pollutes the earth and impures the air. Lastly, the poet writes, the first line in reverse says, remembering no men are foreign and no countries are strange. No men are foreign. The poet wants to say that we should not indulge in war. Also, we are the same in every way. The students are advised to enter summary and do NCERT question in notebook. Thank you.